Hi, I'm Adi from AWS.
Hi, I'm Neeraj from AiDA Technologies, and this is my architecture.
Neeraj, today we'll be talking about AiDA's technologies fraud, waste, abuse, or FWA in short, as a service. Can you tell us a bit about AiDA technology and what are the challenges that you faced that led you to this architecture?
Thank you, Adi. Yes, in AiDA Technologies, we develop solutions for health insurance companies. We help them to solve fraud, waste, abuse identification present in their claims, as well as claims adjudications. The challenges which we used to face with health insurance is the overall turnaround time. When we want to demonstrate the system and deploy the system to clients, it takes almost months. And the challenge is how we can reduce this time. And that's where we decided to develop a FWA SaaS service, which we will be looking at here.
A SaaS service. I can't wait to get into the architecture. Can you talk us through it?
Yes. So this FWA SaaS service exposes a web UI service, which users can log in. So once users are logged in into the system, what they can do, they can upload a file, which usually comprises of number of claims which they want to identify the presence of FWA. And once this file is uploaded, it is notified by it is notified to AWS step functions, where it orchestrates the processing of that file. In that orchestration, what it does, it triggers the AWS Fargate, where our machine learning model is running, which identifies the presence of fraud, waste, abuse present in the claims, and it processes all those claims and stores it into the database. As well as, once this processing is complete, the user is also notified for the completion of this file, as so that they can come back into the UI and look at the dashboard where all the beautiful results are present for their analysis.
I see. So you effectively have put a serverless web UI in front of your AI/ML
yes.
model here on Fargate. But you did mention it took you months to implement this solution on your customer site, which I can only assume is an on-prem deployment. So that makes me curious, why Fargate instead of something like EC2, which closely resembles your on-prem deployment?
So there are two reasons which I say is like, one is with Fargate, because it's a managed container service, the developer productivity will be high. We can directly go and deploy containers. And the other space is like the cost effectiveness. We spin up the AWS Fargate task when a file is uploaded. So it's like on need basis, compute is required. And then once it is done, it is released.
That makes a lot of sense, yeah, especially on the cost efficiency.
Yes.
Now, what about those times when the insurance providers, mm-hmm. they would have got their existing claims management system?
Yes.
So I would have thought it's highly unlikely for an insurance company to have someone like this user here who download the claim from their existing system and then upload it to a web UI. How would you handle this scenario?
Yeah, you're absolutely right on that use case. So what we have done, if you look into this system, we can, high level, we can say like, this was a batch service where users are uploading a file. The other case which you mentioned through integration system is the API cases. What we have done is we have exposed an API through Amazon API Gateway. It's a REST API where client systems can make an API call through the API keys allotted to them. As it is hosted in API Gateway, they provide its own usage plans also. So once they have passed the data in the form of JSON, this is further forwarded to AWS Lambda, where the same machine learning model is running, which we hosted in AWS Fargate. So what it does, it quickly go through that particular claim, identify the presence of the FWA into it, stores the result, as well as it returns it back to the client system which it triggers, so that the client system consumes the result and further process it into their downstreams if required.
I see. So you've got a batch interface, real-time interface. Now, you did mention one thing that sparks my curiosity. The same code were deployed in Lambda and Fargate. Doesn't that mean code duplication?
No, it's not code duplication here. We are deploying the same code across these two, AWS Fargate and Lambda. What we do is like it's the same container which it is deployed. It's just a matter of configuration, which makes it compatible for both the services.
So same container image deployed on Lambda.
Yes. So it's code. We are using the same code.
But still, those are like two different compute services. Why not just Fargate or Lambda?
So there is a reason behind it. As I mentioned, the above case, we classify it as a batch, and here it is a real time. So in real time, they need instance response. In batch, there will be a lot of data which will be coming in. So the reason behind using AWS Fargate and Lambda, in Lambda, we have a timeout of 15 minutes max. So we don't want to cross that threshold. So that's where AWS Lambda helps us in real time case. Whereas AWS Fargate here, the ECS task will run till all the claims are processed.
Makes sense. What about data here? Like, how do you isolate data amongst your customers?
Data is isolated here in the form of schemas. So what we do here is whenever a client is onboarded, a dedicated schema is created for them. And any cross-tenant schema accesses are not allowed. So now when a request arrives, it have permissions to access data within its own schema.
Ah, that's very reassuring. Now, what are some of the benefits that you've realized after this?
So as I mentioned earlier, the main challenge for us was like overall turnaround time. Now it is reduced from months to days. It's a matter of time client onboards and they start to use the system. And of course, as serverless technologies are here, so definitely it's cost-effective solution.
Amazing. Thank you for sharing your architecture with us. And thank you for watching. This is My Architecture.